Welcome back, guys. In the last session, I mistakenly told you that depends on is a annotation, but depends on is an attribute. And we have two attributes of @test, which are depends on groups and depends on methods. We saw depends on methods in the last session. Depends on methods always runs after its parent method runs. Similarly, depends on group runs after its parent groups run. So the main thing is the dependent groups are run only after the groups on which they depend on run. The best way to explain this is through an example. As always, let me start my demo. I will increase the window size over here. Here you go. I have commented all those before and after methods so that you will not get confused when this test runs. So let's have a look at the code. We have a public class annotations. The first method is launch browser, which belongs to groups init. This is the way you specify which groups the method belongs to. Here launch browser belongs to the init group. Next we will see what comes after that. Next we have login method, which also is a part of groups init. Then we have the reservation method. Now pay special attention here. Reservation method belongs to the group main flow, but it also depends on groups init. So only after all the methods in group init are executed will this method run. Next is the reservation to method, which executes only after its dependent group init executes, and it also belongs to main flow. Coming down, we have multi-group dependency. This is how you specify a multi-group dependency over here. What I have done is I have made multi-group dependent method dependent on init and main flow groups, and this method does not belong to any group. So this method will only execute after all the methods in init and main flow groups have been executed. Then comes the checkout method. This is dependent on main flow group. So you will see a difference here. We have the checkout method which was executing last in our execution hierarchy, but now you will see that the multi-group dependent method gets executed last. Let me run this and it will explain things a lot. So it's executed now and we have the execution here. We have 6 tests executed and all have passed. No worries for passing the test for now. We have just put a system out message in that. And let's see the execution hierarchy. I will again copy this in a notepad plus file, so it is pretty evident what is happening. So control C, and I have my notepad open here. Let me delete these contents from my earlier run. So we have first executed method is launch browser. This executes because we don't have any dependencies over here. If you open the test, see, it just belongs to the init group. It does not have any depends on groups or depends on methods. Next we have the login executed. Why does the login execute after launch browser? Let's see. Because the login, even if it does not have any dependency as launch browser, it also belongs to the init group. But if you remember from my first lecture on testng, if we don't have any dependencies, it executes as per alphabetical order. That's the reason launch browser got executed first in this particular group init, and after that we have the login method. I believe it's pretty clear now how the execution takes place. Then coming back, we have the reservation executed. Why does the reservation get executed after that? Because it depends on groups init. Now here you can see we have reservation that depends on init and reservation 2 that also depends on init. But even then, in the same hierarchy, we have reservation getting executed before reservation 2. The same principle applies, which applied to the earlier two tests. Within a group, because these two methods belong to the same group main flow, and within that main flow group, it gets executed in alphabetical order. That's the reason we see reservation getting executed before reservation 2. And next we have the checkout method. As I told you earlier, checkout will get executed first. Before this, we saw that the checkout was getting executed last because of the dependencies we had mentioned in our test. Now, checkout depends on group's main flow. So until and unless all the tests in main flow run, checkout will not get executed. So checkout has executed after all the tests in main flow group have executed. Next we have finally this message. I am dependent on multiple groups. I will only run after init and main flow groups run. So how does this happen? Now here we have mentioned multiple dependencies. This particular method, multi-group dependent, it depends on init group and main flow group. So until and unless all the methods in init and main flow groups have executed, this method will never execute. So that's the reason it executes at the very end. So this is how the execution flow works in case of single group dependency and multiple group dependency. I hope it is pretty clear. If anything is not clear, you can always post a comment, and do remember to subscribe and like my videos. Thanks a lot.